हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष मोहंती। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी अबाउट द नाइट्रोजन साइकिल। सो द फर्स्ट वी विल सी अबाउट द सोर्सेस ऑफ नाइट्रोजन एंड दीज सोर्सेस विच एड्स द नाइट्रोजन इन द एनवायरनमेंट दैट इंक्लूड्स lighting, inorganic fertilizers, nitrogen fixation, animal residues, crop residues, organic fertilizers. So all these sources, they add nitrogen in the environment. So this is the diagrammatic representation of nitrogen cycle, and here that nitrogen cycle which start from the atmospheric nitrogen. So this is the atmospheric nitrogen here, and in atmosphere then nitrogen is added from different sources, and one of that source is the fire. So this fire, it adds the nitrogen in the atmosphere, and this nitrogen from atmosphere, it get utilized by the plant roots with the help of this nitrogen fixation. From these plants, so which includes the cropping, and that is, so this cropping as well as, so these crops or that plants, these are consumed by the animals or cattles, and these cattles that can also leads to the nitrogen. Then from these cattles, that nitrogen get converted in the form of this NH4 plus through manure, and from this NH4+ or ammonium ions, these are taken by the plant or plant roots, that is the plant uptake. Then on the other side, these ammonium ions, they exchange the, or there is a cation exchange, and that leads to the soil particles. Then on the both way, that NH4+ here get converted to soil organic matter, and from the plant root also, that crop residues, they get converted to soil organic matter. Then later on to get converted to NO3-, then denitrification takes place, and it leads to the formation of NO2-. Again that get converted to nitrogen gas. So there is a NO3- leaching takes place here. Then this NH4+ with the help of nitrification get converted to NO2-, and that leads to the formation of NO3-. Then here that fertilizers which are added to the soil, they get converted to again ammonium ions. So in this way that nitrogen cycle takes place. So the next one is here, forms of nitrogen. So that nitrogen which is present in the environment, it is present in different forms. For example, urea, or the formula is CONH2+. Then next one is here ammonia, that is in the gaseous form. Next one is here ammonium ions or ammonium form. Next form of nitrogen is nitrate, that is NO3. Then next one is nitrite, that is NO2. Next form of nitrogen in atmosphere or in environment is atmospheric dinitrogen, that is nitrogen gas. Next one is here organic nitrogen. So these are the different forms. Then the global nitrogen reservoirs. So this is a nitrogen reservoir. This is metric tons of nitrogen, and this is actively cycled nitrogen. So atmospheric nitrogen, then metric ton of nitrogen, it is 3.9 × 10^15, and actively cycled, no. Then ocean soluble salts or biomass, that is 6.9 × 10^11, and in the form of biomass it is 5.2 × 10^8, then recycled. Then land, it is present in the organic matter, and it is 1.1 × 10^11. Cycling is slow. Then biota, 2.5 × 10^10, cycling, yes. So this is about the global nitrogen reservoir. Next point is here, roles of nitrogen. So what are the roles of nitrogen? The first role is plants and bacteria, they utilize the nitrogen in the form of ammonium ions or in the form of nitrate. The next one, it serves as an electron acceptor in anaerobic environment. So here we have seen that NO3 it is a nitrate, NO2 it is a nitrite. Okay, so here these are the roles of nitrogen. The nitrogen is often the most limiting nutrient in soil and water. The next point we will share, nitrogen is a key element for, it is very important in or important part of amino acids. It is important part of nucleic acids including purines and pyrimidines, that is the nitrogen bases. Then it is the important part of cell wall components of a bacteria, that is N-acetyl uramic acid. Then nitrogen cycle includes, so whatever this nitrogen it is present in the environment, it gets recycled in the original form. So this nitrogen cycle includes ammonification or mineralization, immobilization, nitrogen fixation, nitrification and denitrification. See here, this is the ammonification or mineralization. So here there is a formation of ammonia takes place here. This is the atmospheric nitrogen gas here. So this is the ammonium ions, and this ammonium ions it get converted to nitrite, nitrite get converted to nitrate. Again this nitrate get reversibly converted to amino groups here or RnH2, and again it get reversibly converted to ammonium ions. On the other side, this NO3 get converted to NO2, that is nitrate get converted to nitrite, then nitrous oxide, then N2O, okay, and finally again nitrogen gas. This NO2 also get converted to ammonium ions. Then ammonification of mineralization, that includes the, see this is the formation of ammonia, that is called as ammonification or it is known as mineralization. So here nitrogen gas get converted to ammonia, that is called as ammonification. So this is the remaining process that we will see in next slides. And here also this RnH2 get converted to these ammonium ions. So this formation of ammonia, it is called as ammonification or it is the mineralization process. Next point is here that we will see in detail, mineralization or ammonification. So the decomposers, it includes earthworms, termites, slugs, snails, bacteria and fungi. Then they uses extracellular enzymes to initiate the degradation of plant polymers. Then microorganisms, they utilizes proteases, lysozymes, nucleases to degrade these nitrogen containing molecules. So these are the earthworms which are the decomposers here. Then these are the different types of living organisms here that degrade these nitrogenous compounds, so that plants when they get die or when that bacterial cell gets lysed, then they releases organic nitrogen in the soil or in the atmosphere. And this organic nitrogen it get converted to inorganic ions or that nitrogen, that is in the form of ammonia, that is NH3. And when pH is greater than 7.5, there is a converted trap. This nitrogen gas it converted rapidly to ammonium ions. So example is here, urea get converted to ammonia plus 2 molecules of carbon dioxide. Then next one is here, immobilization process. So this immobilization, it is opposite of mineralization, means there is a utilization of that molecules here instead of formation. And it happens when nitrogen is limiting in the environment. The nitrogen limitation, it is governed by the carbon nitrogen ratio, and this carbon nitrogen ratio it is typical for soil microbial biomass and it is 20. So this carbon nitrogen ratio which is greater than 20, that leads to the mineralization. And this carbon nitrogen ratio which is less than greater than 20, that leads to the immobilization. If it is less than 20, then it leads to the mineralization process. And if that carbon nitrogen ratio, if it is greater than 20, then it leads to the immobilization process. this is a nitrogen fixation. Here that nitrogen get converted to ammonium ions. So this is the exact process of nitrogen fixation here. So the first one in that nitrogen fixation, it is energy intensive process. So this is the chemical equation of nitrogen fixation, that N2 plus H plus plus 8 electrons plus 16 molecules of ATP, that gives 2 molecules of ammonia plus 2, that is hydrogen, plus 16 molecules of ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, plus 16 molecules of inorganic phosphate. And these are performed only by a selected bacteria as well as actinomyces. So this nitrogen fixation, it is performed by selected bacteria and actinomycetes, and these are performed in nitrogen fixing crops, for example soybeans. Then the microorganisms which are involved in the nitrogen fixation, that includes Azotobacter, then Benzernica, Azospirillum, Clostridium, Cyanobacteria. So all these are the microorganisms which are involved in nitrogen fixation, and they require the enzyme nitrogenase, with the help of which these microorganisms, they carry out nitrogen fixation. This nitrogen fixation, it is inhibited by oxygen, and it is also inhibited by ammonia, which is an end product, or that we can say end product inhibition. Then rates of nitrogen fixation, that is different for different nitrogen fixing system. For example, in case of rhizobium legume, the nitrogen fixation, it is kilogram nitrogen plus hectare per year, and that is 200 to 300, that is for rhizobium legume. For cyanobacteria moss, 30 to 40. Then for rhizosphere association, it is 2 to 25 kilogram nitrogen plus hectare per hectare per year. And free living bacteria, it is 1 to 2 kilogram of nitrogen per hectare per year. So this is the rates of nitrogen fixation. See, these are the microorganisms here. Then applications to wetlands. So they occur in overlying waters, aerobic soil, then anaerobic soil, oxidized rhizosphere, and leaf or stem surfaces of the plants. So here we will see bacterial fixation. It is occurs mostly in salt marshes. It is absent from low pH peat of northern bogs, and cyanobacteria found in waterlogged soils. So this is the first step here, that is called as nitrification. And this nitrification, it involves the conversion of this ammonia to NO2, that is the nitrite. So this is called as nitrite, and conversion of this nitrite to nitrate, that is called as the nitrification. Okay, so here two steps reactions that occur together. First step, it is catalyzed by the nitrosomonas, where the two molecules of ammonium ions plus three molecules of oxygen get converted to two molecules of NO2 plus two molecules of H2O plus four protons. So this is the first step, and it is catalyzed by the nitrosomonas bacteria. See here, this is the first step, NH4 get converted to NO2, and here the microorganisms which carry out this nitrification, first step of nitrification, that is the nitrosomonas. This is the second step of nitrification, in which that NO2 get converted to NO3. So here second step, it is catalyzed by nitrobacter. So this second step, this one, it is catalyzed by nitrobacter, it is catalyzed by nitrosomonas. And in second step, that two molecules of NO2 minus plus O2 get converted to two molecules of NO3. So here this is the nitrate. So conversion of these ammonium ions to nitrate through this nitrite, that is called as nitrification. So this is the two step we have seen here. The next one is here, the optimum pH is between 6.6 to 8. Then if pH is less than 6, then the rate of nitrification is slowed. If pH is less than 4.5, then this reaction is inhibited. So here that we have seen, these are the two steps here. nitrification. So effect of pH we have seen here, if that pH is less than 4.5, then that reaction is inhibited. So in which, that is the question for you, in which type of wetlands do you think nitrification occurs? The next type of nitrogen cycle is denitrification. So what is this denitrification? So conversion of NO3 to NO2, then nitrous oxide, then this N2O, and finally nitrogen gas. So this is called as denitrification process. So this denitrification, it removes a limiting nutrient from the environment. So this is the reaction, 4NO3 minus plus C6H12O6. It leads to the 2 molecules of nitrogen gas plus 6 molecules of H2. Then it is inhibited by oxygen. It is not inhibited by ammonia, and it is a microbial reaction. And this nitrate, it is the terminal electron acceptor here. Then looking at the nitrogen cycle through the eye of ammonia. So here nitrogen cycling in wetlands progresses more rapidly where there is a thin oxygenated soil layer present. So this is the nitrogen surface water, oxidized layer, reduced layer. Then this is the that ammonia, it is high. Then oxidized layer, it is low because it is inhibited by oxygen, and there is a slow diffusion. So this is biodegradation, carbon nitrogen ratio is less than 20, so that causes the increasing ammonia. So carbon nitrogen ratio, it is greater than 20, then it inhibits the formation of ammonia. Okay, so here NO3 is high, then it leads, it converted to nitrogen, that is called as the nitrification process. So this is nitrification. NO3 is high, NO3 is low here, so that leads to the leaching. Then nitrogen gas here, so get converted to nitrogen gas, and this is called as denitrification. So this NO3 get converted to nitrogen gas, that is called as denitrification. And finally, if there is any questions, you can ask in comment box. Thank you for watching this video. If you are not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this YouTube channel and share this video with your friends. Thank you.